Good morning, brothers and sisters in Christ. Welcome to our English home worship service. As we gather together, let's prepare our hearts to worship the Lord. Let's quieten our hearts and with reverence welcome God's presence to this time of worship. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ be with you all. Let us worship God in spirit and in truth, and follow His ways in this hour of worship and always. The call to worship this morning is taken from the Psalms 92, verse 1 to 4. It is good to praise the Lord and make music to your name, O Most High, proclaiming your love in the morning and your faithfulness at night, to the music of the 10-string lyre and the melody of the harp. For you make me glad by your deeds, Lord. I sing for joy at what your hands have done. Let us now worship our Lord by singing our opening song. First is Holy, 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 followed by The Path of Grace and Because He Lives.
Early in the morning, our soul shall rise. the shepherd of my life. Through the hills and valleys, you're always by my side. Calling me by name, you've chosen me with love. Blessing me abundantly, your promise will never change. Every step we take, you lead us with your grace. Your love, your hand will hold us close to you. Every step we take, you lead us with your guide us through the path of grace. because he lives. And then one day, across the river, I'll find life's final war with hate. And then as death gives way to
Let's go to God in prayer. Our Heavenly Father, we open our hearts, minds, and souls to worship you. Thank you that today we dwell in your kingdom and live in your presence. Father, as we gather together in our homes and look forward to your presence with us, we also join all our Christian families across the world to glorify your holy name. Come be with us. Inspire us and lead us in our time together. Hear our prayers, O God, for we offer them in the name of Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. May I invite all of you now to spend some time praying for? Firstly, let us pray for our government and the Ministry of Health to formulate an effective MCO exit strategy. Secondly, we pray for continued adoption of a more prudent and cautious lifestyle by the community following relaxation of the MCO and against racial prejudice across the globe. You may pause this video for a time of group prayer and then resume the video after you have concluded praying.
Shall we come to the Lord with a word of prayer? Let us pray. Almighty God, we know that there are many among us today with special needs in their own lives and need your special touch and reassurance right now. We come to you, O God, that we are now praying to you, seeking your guidance and your blessings. There are also numerous physical problems, and we don't understand why these things come into our lives, and we are tempted to question you, and our faith is tested. Oh Lord, sometimes it is to the limit. We pray that their faith will not fail during these days or this long period of attempting. Some have family and relationship problems. They need special grace to see them through. Bring healing, and we truly believe your healing power. Jesus healed, and he still heals today. While he was on earth, our Lord Jesus healed thousands of people, and he still heals the many sick today. Have mercy upon us, O Lord. Restore, O God, the abundant lives that you have blessed us and promised us. And these abundant lives, which include health, strength, and joy. Loving God, we pray that you will comfort us in our sufferings, lend skill to the hands of our healers, and bless the means used for our cure. Give us such confidence in the power of your grace that even when we are afraid, we may put our whole trust in you. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.
Let us continue our worship by the reading of the scriptures. Please open your Bibles to Hebrews chapter 12, verse 1 to 13. Let us take turns to read aloud a verse each from this passage. You may now pause the video and have members open their Bibles to read Hebrews chapter 12, verse 1 to 13. We are so glad that we have Reverend Yau's with us this morning. Before Reverend Yau's sharing on the God's message, the Father in the Bible, let us prepare and open our hearts and mind to receive His message.
Welcome to join us to worship our God on this special day, which is designated as Father's Day. May we first wish all fathers happy Father's Day. And the topic of my sermon today is about the Father. What does the Bible talk about the fathers? What did they do in the scripture? In fact, when Jesus taught us the Lord's Prayer, we address God in heaven as our Father in heaven. God is our Father. And see how God as a Father treats His children or His chosen tribe. Now, the relationship between God and the believers is illustrated as Father and Son. And let us take a quick look at the fathers in the Bible. Number one, the fathers in the Bible blessed their children. For example, Abraham blessed Isaac, and Isaac, as a father, blessed his son Jacob, and Jacob blessed his 12 children, and his 12 children became the chosen people of God, or they became the 12 tribes of Israel. So the fathers blessed one another after their generation. That is what the fathers did. Let us take one example. I've taken from the book of Genesis, chapter 49, verses 22 to 28, where Jacob blessed his children one by one. It says here, shows us how Jacob as a father and how he blessed his 12 children. Joseph is a fruitful bough. A fruitful bough by a well. His branches run over the wall. The archers have bitterly grieved him, shot at him, and hit him. But his bow remained in strength, and the arms of his hands were made strong. And by the hands of the mighty God of Jacob, and from there is the shepherd, the stone of Israel. And by the God of your father, who will help you, and by the Almighty, who will bless you with blessings of heaven above, blessings of the deep that lies beneath, blessings of the breast and of the womb. And the blessings of your father have excelled the blessings of my ancestors up to the utmost bound of the everlasting hills. They shall be on the head of Joseph, and on the crown of the head of him who was separate from his brothers. Benjamin is a ravenous wolf. In the morning he shall devour the prey, and at night he shall divide the spoil. All these are the 12 tribes of Israel, and this is what their father spoke to them. And he blessed them. He blessed each one according to his own blessing. So from this passage, we can see how Jacob as a father blessed all his 12 children, and the blessings continue to flow upon generation after generation. You see how effective it will be when a father blesses his children. Likewise, God blesses each and every one of us, and his blessings overflow in our lives. Secondly, the father in the Bible disciplines his children, especially quoted from Hebrews 12, verse 5 to 11. You know, God severely punishes the Israelites when they sin against him, when they go wrong, when they go according to their own way against the will of God. Remember one thing, the motive behind disciplining is love. God loves and he disciplines. The Father loves us and he disciplines us. From Hebrews 12, verse 5 to 9, it says, "My son, do not despise the chastening of the Lord, nor be discouraged when you are rebuked by him. For whom the Lord loves, he chastens, and scourges every son whom he receives. If you endure chastening, God deals with you as with sons. For what son is there whom father does not chasten? But if you are without chastening, of which all have become partakers, then you are illegitimate and not sons. Furthermore, we have had human fathers who corrected us, and we paid them respect. Shall we not much more readily be in subjection to the Father of spirits and live?" So from here, we learn and we understand. Sometimes we may feel that, why does God treat us in that way? That might be the disciplines of God. God disciplines us because he loves us. He wants us to receive his blessings. He never wants us to go astray, away from the way of his will, away from the path from God's blessings. So when a father loves his children, he disciplines his children. Likewise, God loves us and he disciplines us. Number three, from the Bible, we also learn that the father always forgives his son. No matter what big mistake or error the son might have committed. I'm sure we are all familiar with the story of the prodigal son, a parable told by Jesus in the book of Luke, chapter 15. We are familiar with the story. We know how the second son took away the wealth from his father and left home. But finally, he encountered difficulties and even faced the fortune of death. But finally, he woke up. He repented. He realized he should go back home to ask for forgiveness. But then look what the father did when the prodigal son returned to the home. Verse 20 of Luke 15 says, "And he rose and came to his father. But when he was still a great way off, his father saw him and had compassion, and ran and fell on his neck and cursed him. And the son said to him, 'Father, I have sinned against heaven and in your sight, and am no longer worthy to be called your son.'" How did the father respond? He did not scold him. He did not even say a single negative word. But then the father said to his servants, "Bring out the best robe and put it on him, and put the ring on his hand and sandals on his feet." Simply, these three actions symbolizes how the father forgives the son and accepts the son as his child and rebuilds the father and son relationship. Putting the best robe on his body, meaning from now onwards, he's going to live a new life. To put a ring, to reestablish the good and the close relationship between a father and a son, and put the sandals on his feet. Presently, the father will always protect the son, guide the son, lead the son, and give the son peace. And finally, the father said, "Bring the fatted calf here and kill it, and let us eat and be merry. For this son was dead and is alive again. He was lost and he is found." And they began to be merry. You know, how happy it would be when a sinner repents and goes back to the Father. So our Father in heaven is like the Father in the parable of the prodigal son. Our Father God in heaven always waiting for sinners to repent, to come back to his own original and eternal home. That is how a father is described, who forgives, accepts, and re-establishes the good bond between a father and a son. Fourthly, the father in the Bible is like a shepherd. He protects his children and guides them on the right way. We are very familiar with Psalm 23. Let me quote from the first three verses. It says that the Lord is my shepherd. I shall not want. He makes me to lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside the still waters. He restores my soul. He leads me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Now, our Father in heaven, our God, is like a shepherd, like a father who guides us, who leads us. When we depend and trust in our God as the Father in heaven, we will not be lack of anything. That's why he say, I shall not want. It's more than what we need. It's more than what we desire. And he leads us on the right path. He protects us and he guides us onto the right way. Finally, the fifth point, the Father so loves the world that he even gives his only son to the world. From John 3:16, a father, as a father, though he may be very strict, but then he always loves us, like how God loves us. We are familiar with John 3:16. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, that whoever believes in him should not perish, but will have everlasting life. God loves us as a father loves his children and are even willing to sacrifice even their own lives just to protect, to save, and to bless his children. That is how our God in heaven does for us. He loves us so much, and he even is willing to sacrifice his own son, Jesus Christ, to die for your sins, for my sins, for everybody's sins on the cross. This is the best love expressed in action. So from the Bible, we can see how God as a father and how fathers love their children. Let us celebrate Father's Day today in any manner. But remember, we have our God in heaven who is our Father. He loves us so much. He blesses his best. He blesses everything just for our sake. Let us be thankful to him and continue to trust him. Once again, wish everybody, every father, a happy Father's Day. Let us pray. Father God, we thank you for the precious word in the scripture, where you are described as a caring and a loving father. We are so thankful to you. But at the same time on earth, you also provide us with a father who loves us as you have loved us. We pray for them and we also bless them to grant them good health. And we also pray that God, they will also come to the Lord if they have not received Jesus Christ, that they will also receive the eternal salvation. Grant them good health, peace, and love. O Lord, once again, help us to love one another as you have loved us. All this we pray in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.
Church News. Today is Father's Day, so come and join us in wishing all fathers a happy Father's Day. May the good Lord continue to bless them and guide them in providing for and looking after their families. Offertory. Those who wish to give online to the church may deposit into any of our church bank accounts, either to UOB account or Hong Leong Bank account. Please email your transaction slip with details of your name and pledge number, if any, to our church email address, or you may WhatsApp transaction slip to Brother Jun Ming at 019-397-5452. Thank you. Closing hymn. Let us respond together in this closing hymn. This is my Father's work.
This is my Father's work, and to my listening ears, all nature sings and round me rings the music of the spheres. This is my Father's work.
Let us now come to the Lord and receive His blessings. And now may the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all, now and forever. Amen.
This concludes our home worship service today. Do continue to fellowship with one another and take some time today to reflect on the message you have just heard. God bless you. Bye-bye.